I mean, how much further can the Swissy and the yen go, do you think?
Well, I think it depends really on how much the tensions in the Ukraine continue to increase, and as well how much the slowdown in China continues to impact on sentiment. I mean, clearly both can go considerably further. Mm. The yen's the obvious one with regard to this, given it's the natural funding currency. I personally think that if it did continue to get worse on the geopolitical side, could you see a dollar yen that trades reasonably below 100? Yes, of course you could. But that's a factor of geopolitics.
What is the greater concern, do you think, for the markets? Is it what's going on in the Crimea, or is it China? I.e. what's happening really on our doorstep?
I actually think it's China, to be honest. I think that's wrong, because I do think that actually what's happening on the doorstep of Europe should be getting far greater attention. But I think if we're being realistic and we look at the way the market's performed, it's probably got more to do with the slowdown in China. And again, it is a fair thing to actually worry about, given the scale of the economy and the impact it does have on Greater Asia and indeed on exports around the world.
Let's talk about the euro as well. This is an interesting story. Undermined yesterday, comments from Draghi speaking in Vienna. He said the strength of the currency increasingly relevant to the bank's assessment of price stability. This has worried the market, of course. What does he do next, though? I mean, this is the big question,
absolutely.
Everyone's asking themselves. What do you think he does next?
Well, I think it's a fascinating story, because quite clearly, first of all, Mr. Draghi's been given the go-ahead, if you like, by Mr. Wiedemann's comments the other day. Mm. Germany's clearly worried about the strength of the euro. So now we've got jawboning. That's not unsurprising. The question is, what happens were euro to break beyond 140? If we look at past history, we could argue that most central banks recently, when they wanted to weaken the currency, have used QE. Mm. It's worked well in Japan. You could argue it's worked well in the US and UK. It's far harder in Europe because, of course, you've got 16 or 17 nations. Ironically, I think actually it might be easier for them to intervene, particularly given nobody's thinking about it at the moment. It's theoretical. But I think it's something you shouldn't entirely discount.
Is this a view held quite widely among your peers?
I don't think anybody at all is talking about intervention, because I think most people remember over the course of the last decade that there's been a constant pullback by the Europeans from the idea of intervention, particularly because they could never do it multilaterally.
You set a massive precedent, though, don't you?
Oh, you do. But if you go back to a pre-1995 world, Germany and the Bundesbank never had any issue intervening to keep dollar mark in relatively well-defined ranges. The big surprise right now would be to go back to that kind of world.